Ray.
Hey, you said a moment ago that Ray-chan is dead. What do you mean by that?
This is a haven in the rift. It is linked to the collective unconsciousness. During the short moment after Ray died, and her soul was fading, she wandered here. That's why I came. To tell her that her time had come to an end.
No! You're lying!
Ray, your memories should have returned.
I'm scared!
There's nothing to be scared of. I'll be with you.
I'm not scared to die. I'm scared that I had nothing. I'm scared I was born and I died for nothing. Why was I born? My whole life was suffering and envy. I couldn't even go to school. It would be fine if there was any meaning to all that. If there was a point, I'd be okay with it. But if there was no point, I can't accept it. For me to die like that, that this is the end. I haven't even done anything. I haven't found anything.
You wouldn't understand. After all, you're still alive.
A shadow.
Ray-san.
What is this?
This doesn't make sense. Why would something like this appear?
Was that Ray-chan's shadow?
No. Perhaps the shadows here have gone berserk. They may be trying to prevent me from taking Ray away.
Taking Ray-chan?
They don't want to let go of this place. If Ray and I leave, it will disappear. So to prevent that... But... How can ordinary shadows have this kind of power?
This world will disappear? Is that because Ray-chan created it? Didn't you say before that Ray-chan created the school?
No, I created it. I had only remembered some of the details at that time. In actuality, I used my powers to base this place on Ray's memories.
Her memories?
Zen-san, won't you tell us everything about you and Ray-san, and how we may save her?
Yes. My true name is Kronos. I am one of those beings you refer to as death. I had come to take away a girl whose life had ended. That girl was Ray. My duty was to lead her to where all life returns. My name is Kronos, an aspect of death.
Death?
Your time in life has ended. Thus, you must come with me. There is nothing that can overturn this decision. That is all.
I died?
That is correct. Your time has come. None can escape this fate. Are you not going to say anything? Most humans argue bitterly at this point. Those who don't typically welcome me. Why are you not saying anything? What is this human? Ray remained silent, thinking back. She was in utter despair, so deep that she could not cry, or even scream. But I couldn't understand that at the time. I took an interest in her, and had an idea. I wondered if I could make this girl who had fallen silent speak. That was all. It was just an idle means of killing time. I expended a fraction of my power, just for that purpose. I created this based on your memories. Yasogami High, the place you dreamed of, no?
Yasogami High.
You finally opened your mouth.
This is the school I was supposed to attend. I heard its bell from my hospital room. I imagine that there must be a large old clock tower there. I heard the bell every single day, and I'd hear the laughter of everyone who attended school there, too. I dreamed of this place. I wish to come here someday. I wish to make tons of friends. Now, I'm finally here. Look, Mr. Death. These are my treasures. They were probably put in with me into my casket. A stuffed rabbit. Isn't he cute? He's from a picture book. A nurse made these clothes for him. And this is a ring. When I was little, my mom bought it for me at a festival. She said I would have a beautiful wedding. I asked if Prince Charming would come. She said he would. My mom disappeared after that. She said she didn't want me. Maybe she shouldn't have given birth to me. My name's Nico. The nurse guessed it's because my mom wanted me to smile and be happy, but that's not it. I was named Nico because I was the second child. My mom said so. That's all it means. See this? It's my hair. The nurse kept a bit of it when it was still long and pretty. She gave it to me after all my hair got shaved off, but it didn't cheer me up much. I yelled, "Why would you do this to me?" I cried and got angry, but I couldn't throw it away.
You're holding one more thing.
What's this? A letter? I didn't know about this one. It says, "Please rest in peace. Oh. It's from the girl in the bed next to me. She was 3 years older than me. Her name was Yuki-chan. She was really pretty and nice, and always comforted me when I cried. Yuki-chan never cried. She'd smile even after the painful tests. I really looked up to her. But she was discharged from the hospital. She sent a lot of letters. They'd say things like, I'm doing well. You can do it, Nico-chan. I thought I did my best, but I wonder if I had to try harder. In peace. That's so cruel when she's still alive. I bet she's laughing, happy to be alive. It's not fair! Why only me? Why was I born? Why did I have to be born? I have nothing. No friends, no parents, not even my health. I prayed to God every day, and not one prayer was granted. Why did I exist? What was the point of my life? Thank you, Mr. Death, for showing me this place. But I didn't want to see it. Everyone else gets to come here every day. But I'm gonna die alone. This is too cruel. That's enough. I've had enough! Hurry up and kill me! Take me away right now! I don't want to see this anymore!
And then she tried to gouge out her own eyes.
Her eyes?
In death, one is bodiless, but the soul can still be harmed. Hers was meant to disappear. But still, I shielded her eyes in surprise and stole away her memories. I'm...
Huh? My name. What was it? My name.
Your name is... Nico.
Nico?
No. Let's say it's something else. Something... you'd like more.
What was wrong? You're trembling. Are you scared?
Scared?
Don't worry, I'm here with you. You're not alone.
Yes. I will ensure that you are also not alone. Always. You can call me Zin.
Zin?
It means one who lives with you.
Zin, how do you write that?
Right.
I'll make it Zen. That means nice, because you're a good person.
A good person.
Zen, do you not like it?
It will do. Thank you. Your name is Philae.
Philae?
Philae.
Philae. It's hard.
Philae.
Philae. Oh, I said it! Philae. Is Ray okay? So are Zen and Ray. It's nice to meet you, Zen.
Yes.
Zen? What's wrong? Are you hurt somewhere? Please don't cry.
sorry. Ray.
I don't know how to describe what took place within me at that moment. If I had been possessed of a heart, I would have wanted to tear it out and crush it. It was that intense.
A person can never come back to life. And yet you granted Rayson's wish that she had while she was still clinging to life. It's as if you prepared a banquet for a starving man, and then forbade them to eat it. What you did may have been cruelty on that level.
Yes. I hurt her. And not only that, I stole her memories based on a twinge of some emotion. I hid my mistake.
Zen.
Time flows and swallows everything. Kronos obeys time and is a harbinger of the ends of time. I am Kronos. I cannot turn my back on that duty. But at the very least, I wish to give her the answer she longed for. I wanted to give her the reason for why she lived that she wanted so desperately. But I couldn't figure it out. I knew no life, nor death, nor time. I didn't even have a heart. I didn't have a single word of comfort to give her. That's why I suspended things.
You chose not to take Rayson away.
Yes. I left my powers as Kronos to a split half of myself and hid it in this clock tower. I sealed my memories as well and hid them in a number of rooms in this school, along with Ray's things. Those rooms eventually became labyrinths. To prevent the truths within them from being discovered, the guardians in their depths also sprung from Ray, so as not to let anyone at those truths.
So that's how the labyrinths and guardians came to be. But weren't Ray's memories gone by that point?
To forget something means to seal one's memories deep below the conscious mind. True. Ray remembers nothing, but in her unconscious, she was always frightened of the truth. Ray most likely ate so much because she wanted to live. She yearned for life.
That's why she was eating all those delicious things? Oh, Ray-chan!
I locked it all away, averting my eyes from the truth, and decided to spend a long, peaceful time here with Ray. It would last until I could tell her why she had lived. It was I who trapped Ray here. For my own selfish reasons.
So that's what happened.
I'm sorry to have dragged you all into this. You heard the bell earlier, yes? The fourth lock should be released now. You can return to whence you came.
Return? But...
this place is unstable. It will vanish along with Ray, its master. You should go back, while you still can.
But what about you, Zen?
I'll go to Ray. I promised to be with her. And I can't leave that girl alone.
And you're planning on doing that by yourself? The clock tower must be swarming with powerful shadows. And that spider's waiting at the top. Can you really do something about this alone?
I have to.
You moron, you ain't getting it. If you seriously want to save Ray, you gotta be willing to take us along.
You need to finish what you started. We'll watch you do it.
Akihiko.
He's right. We may as well watch you from the closest place we can. That's what companions do, no?
Companions. I see. Will you come with me? Thank you.
There is no reason to thank us. I wish... In fact, everyone here wishes to save Rhaesan. We should be the ones begging you to take us with you. Zen-san, take us, dammit, I say.
Yes. Of course. I want you all to come with me.
Cool. Then it's decided. We can do this, Zen-kun. Once we head back and get ourselves prepared, let's go together, okay? I'm sure Rhaechan is waiting for you.
Right.
All the locks have been released, and the doors are open. You may now return to the worlds from which you originally came. This door leads to my guest's world.
And this door, in turn, should lead to my guests.
It's possible for you to return to your worlds right now. Will you?
I knew that you would say so. We wish to remain here and see where your journey leads to as well.
There's something I'd like to talk to you about. Excuse me, but will the rest of you please step out for a moment?
Oh, then why don't we go find something else to do? Let's rest up and restore our spirits.
I overheard Zen-san's story. So his true name was Kronos. Yes, but he himself is not precisely the god of myth. This place connects deep into human consciousness. If he is a native, it means humans gave birth to him. When one's body perishes, the mind returns to the Sea of Souls. Many people think of it in this way. They believe they are taken away to the afterlife through the guidance of a higher power. That imagery aggregated to give rise to those with the role of death. That young man is one such being. I now understand why this place had to be a culture festival. Festivals were originally ceremonies, ritual practices to put souls to rest. Rhaesan's soul, on the verge of disappearing, wandered into this haven in the Rift. Because she was unable to escape her illusion, even in death, this ceremony was necessary to calm her. This is the last paradise constructed by a pitiable soul. That may be why we residents of the Velvet Room were drawn to it. Where one comes from, and where they will go, everyone, even us, searches for the answer to that. I make this request of you. Please set this poor soul free. I'm not worried at all. Knowing you, I'm certain you can save them. I'll be waiting for that time to come.
I've chosen! Persona Change! Power of the Wild Card!
Orpheus! Izanagi!
Arsene!
Let's keep this up!
Come forth, Thanatos!
Come! Izanagi no Okami!
Ravage them, Sazanael!
What a stylish power!
Stay in formation. No changes.